own it, you better never let it go. You only get one shot, do not miss your chance to blow. This opportunity comes once in a lifetime. You better lose yourself in the music the moment you own it, you better never let it go. You only get one shot, do not miss your chance to blow. This opportunity comes once in a lifetime. You better. The soul's escaping through this hole that is gaping. This world is mine for the taking. Make me king as we move toward a new world order. A normal life is boring, but superstardom's close to postmortem. It only grows harder, homie grows hotter. He blows, it's all over, these fools is all on him. Coast to coast shows, he's known as the Globetrotter. Lonely roads, God only knows he's grown farther. From home, he's no father. He goes home and barely knows his own daughter. But hold your nose, cause here goes the cold water. These fools don't want him no more, he's cold product. They moved on to the next mo who flows, he knows dove and sold nada. The soul popper is told and unfolds. I suppose it's old partner, but the beat goes on.
Hello and welcome to SportsVision, the magazine. WTMV show panel, Mike Craig and Fajita there, and a host of players that we're going to show you here in baseball action and all kinds of stuff. They're all here.
One shot, one opportunity.
To what?
That's what Eminem says. You got one shot, once in a lifetime.
You like Eminem, don't you?
Like an earthquake in the middle of the night. It's a once in a lifetime.
You like Eminem, don't you?
I did, yeah. Well, just that song. I can't stand white rap, any kind of rap, really.
I like his brother Mars. You know his brother Mars?
Yeah. Anyway, I felt the tremble last night.
Did you?
I woke up Denise. I actually did.
You were thinking about me?
Yeah. I thought maybe you passed wind or something. I didn't know what happened. I knew that it
hurt the
for some reason. I got a tremor. Hey, listen, we got lots of stuff. We got Okoye.
What happened? Okoye. You woke up Denise and what?
Lake Forest, student body game.
Nothing.
And then we got Bradley.
It was a helicopter problem.
It was a helicopter. Sorry, honey. Bradley, and of course, we also have. Hey, we got a dedication to one of our great sponsors, Sterling Point, developing that area out there, Red Food Drive. Got a new Walmart coming in. Got a little segment on them because they're such good people, good sponsors, Courtney and Betty McGrady. But I'll tell you what, we better race so we can get it all in for you. And we're going to start with...
Speaking of racing.
Okoye, 8th grade versus Lake.
All right, here we go.
Student body game.
Student body game, and here we got a little pregame
pepper,
as they say, salt, little salt pepper.
It rained all day that day. We're going to show a little mud here.
Well, they cleaned it up.
They're
all cleaned up.
Playing in the mud.
The players are out there cleaning up.
What is this?
All right. We're going to move to the top of the first after they get it going. Top of the first, catcher Aaron Short slaps a double for Okoye into left center. Good shot by Short. Say that fast five times. Justin Spain, just in time, up next, number 5, would follow. He slaps.
He's coming there.
Right there. Number 9, I'm sorry, I said 5. They slap a single into right center field, scoring short. Stop it, Kavita. Get in there. 1-0 Okoye. And this is after one half inning. It's 1-0 Okoye Little Colts, as you can see right there. Bottom of the first, Justin Knight would walk for Lake Forest. He would wind up stealing second base, as you'll be able to see coming up here. Right there, he steals second.
Notice the camera angle. It was raining, so Denise was up in the
scores. I like that angle right there. All right, Dakota Bolton hits a slow roller to the shortstop. Ball would be thrown away. Knight would score. However, Bolton is caught trying to steal. All right, Bolton. No relation to Michael. Maybe he is after getting caught right there. Of course, Michael Bolton's a pretty good softball player.
Michael Bolton got caught.
All right. Nice for Aaron Short. 1-1 after one, as you can see right there. Oh, yeah. We move on, top of the second, Okoye Tyler Hogan. Hogan would drop a single into right field. Hogan would steal second base. Watch. But it's just a little too late. Good second, but the threat would end right there. We move on to the bottom of the second inning. Tim Lynn would get hit by a pitch, taking one for the team, walks on to first base, and then Lynn says, you know, it made me so upset, I'm going to go ahead and steal second. And he does so, right there. Top of the third now, Drew Nunley, number 34, would rip a ball to the shortstop, not handled, beats it out. Good hustle by Nunley. He's followed by TC, Travis Craig in here. And Nunley would steal second base. Now Craig gets a pretty good smack right here. for the shortstop. It's not handled. He beats it out as well. So now we've got first and third, the Colts. Craig and Nunley would get together here on a little base trickery.
Trickery job.
Tragen would try and draw a throw. And there, see, pitcher throws to get Nunley. But he's looking at Tragen. Throw it to get Nunley. No, Tragen's safe.
All thrown away there.
There it is. All right. TJ Smith, huh?
Didn't do the good, great job.
Follows with a single to score Craigan. Guess what? It's now 3-1 after 2.5 innings of play. We move on now to the top of the fourth. Brandon Elrod, you saw the scoreboard there shortly. Brandon Elrod with a single right here. Nice pop. Elrod would move on to second base on a steal, as you'll see. Right here because of the high camera angle. Good shot right there. All right, Nunley would come home.
Single home, Elrod.
Elrod
comes home.
Come home, Brandon. The score now is 4-1 after 3.5. After the score by Elrod, number one in your program, number one in your heart. Bottom of the fourth, Zach Roberts would single for Lake Forest. He would go on to steal second base. So if you don't stop that. Here's the one.
Y'all are bad tempered.
Man, just leave him alone. All right. Lynn would single to right field, scoring. Roberts. He would take single. He takes second base on a throw in. 4-2 now. After four.
That's where it ends up.
Game would end.
To the seventh grade game, John Kleiner is going to lead it off for Lake Forest with a single. John put one out in the right field.
Didn't mention he also is single.
He is single. He's followed by Zach Roberts, had a great game. Shot to second base, not handled. First and second for Lake Forest in the home half of the game number two. And here is Cole Kierstad, and he's going to walk to load up the bases. Then we have another walk. To force home a run. Lake Forest takes over a 1-0 lead to begin with. Number 21, Travis Moses, you've seen there getting ready to get in the box.
Oh,
he also walks to make it 2-0. And now we have a ground out to second base. They try to force the runner at home. Watch this, they can't get him. And the runners are all safe. It's 3-0 Lake Forest, leading the Colts in the seventh grade game. Here we go. T.J. Biden now is going to hit a blooper. It's going to fall in, but there is going to be a force out at second. The man had to hold, but a run does score. Fourth run for Lake Forest, 4-0 after inning of play. Top two, Will Jenkins is going to be safe. That's a little intro pop-up. Pretty good effort by second base. He just kind of fell into a bad spot. Will Jenkins on there. Jenkins is going to show some wheels because Jenkins, not Willie, of course. He can't run like that. He's on second base. It's Will Jenkins.
But can Will Jenkins make chili?
No, or chicken salad. And yeah. Will goes to third base, Will Jenkins does. Not Willie Jenkins, no. Willie Jenkins is not playing baseball at a goal. Here we go. Kylie Vanning's going to walk. He's going to make it first and third throw, Coley. And Dustin Cook is going to hit one at second base. Now watch this. Everybody's safe.
He can
make chicken salad. Look at that. Everybody's safe. Coley's got something going. Jenkins scores 4-1 Lake. 4-1 now, Lake Forest ahead. Wild pitch is going to move all the runners up. Here they go. And they're all up now. DJ Morgan's going to walk to load him again. And then Stephen Brown is going to work another walk to force in a run. It's 4-2. So Okoye's sneaking back in. Adam Heinemann's going to hit a dribbler down the first base line. Watch him hustle here. They
as
barely get on
the satellite.
That's right. Look at this. He's going to slide. He missed the ball. That's good because he would have been out. But look at that. Catcher falls over the pitcher. Everybody's safe. Heinemann going to take second on the throw there. Nobody at home because the catcher's trying to make a play. Everybody's safe. 4-4. So he ends up tying it up on that play after an inning and a half. And it's starting to rain. I'm going to be checking some of that blurry rain. Raining hard there. They kept on playing. They're going to bottom two. Roberts back up again. He's going to get on in the air. Here it is. Gets through the shortstop. Roberts is on. Roberts again, as in seventh grade, he seemed to have a lot of will, so it seems to get hard to throw him out. Anyway, Robert's going to take second. Hurry up, right here. There he goes, man. Of course, a lot of times, seventh grade games, they can take third. Then that not the eighth grade games, in seventh grade.
Once in a while, they can take home.
Once in a while, there you go. Kirsten now is going to smack a double to center field, or the right field. It is, and look at that, he's going to go right down the line, he's going to hug the chop, and he's going to get the second base and bring home a run. Next batter coming up here is going to get hit by a pitch once here for the team. And again, you can see it right there. Well, he got one right where Travis got last week, right in the old rumpus. He's standing in the dugout. Travis Moses is going to reach on an infield hit right here. It's going to make bases loaded. Good effort.
He's going to park the way to first base.
But there it is. Moses parts his way to first. Good line right there. Here's Red Enzo. 5-4. Lake Forest. And look at it. It's in the three. Now the umps are going to talk about ending the ball game right here after this timeout. So let's hold the top half. Jenkins going to get a single. They're down 4-3. They have to score one or the game is over. Lake Forest wins. There they are. So we're saying too much water, too much rain. Touchstone bunts the ball. Jenkins, he had stolen. He's going to end up getting home right here. Getting stolen second, bound the third on the bunt, kept on moving. It's tied at 5. Here we go. Now we've got Cook, the catcher. Rifling a shot at the center field. And then Cook, they often do in seventh grade. Going to steal second. And what's he going to
do?
Steal third. Get him on second, first though, one at a time. Steals third. But look at that.
Oh, hey.
The throw was not good.
Stealing home.
It's coming all the way home. And now Okoe leads 6-5. So we're going to the bottom half. Now it's Lake Forest that has the score or game's over. So see the rain coming down right there. TJ Biden's going to walk for Lake Forest. Biden's going to steal second base. He's biding his time there first. And Biden's going to steal second. and then Biden's going to steal third. He's just 90 feet away. Biden his time on third base. Biden his nails here, waiting to see if he can come in or not. But look at this. There is a bunt that's missed, and it's going to be a squeeze. And they have to throw the ball away. They had him locked up. Game would have been over. Okoe would have won. But no, it's tied in a game that the umps are saying it's raining. Let's go home. And guess what? That's where it ends. 6-6.
It got dark all of a sudden.
Because they scored a tie, but no more runs. And so kissing your sister is 6-6 tie. Right
have you
there.
Ever kissed your sister?
No, I haven't. I don't have a sister. Otherwise, you know, no. But no. No, I haven't.
I knew
here we go.
Eighth
grade action.
Like
Okoe 4-2 over Lake Forest. Seventh grade, 6-6 tie due to rain. We've got one more announcement here on this one.
Here we go. Middle. All right, here we go. We move on to football news. And our man Tyrese Warren has signed to play with Hibbin Community College. And, of course, from there he's going to move on to bigger and better things. And
that's we'll in Minnesota. Tyrese. Congratulations.
Tyrese in Division I football.
All right.
All right, let's move on to commercial. We'll be back with more Sports Vision after this.
Hiya, dessert fellas. We have several homemade pies. Yummy. Pecan pie, blueberry. Strawberry cheesecake, my favorite. You got milkshakes, you put a scoop of French vanilla ice cream on top of that. It's not really French.
Want to get a great $6 restaurant burger without the restaurant? The $6 burger, $3.95 at Hardee's.
Checking the cash, checking the cash.
You got a cash emergency, you got a money mayday. We pass your personal check and then we hold it till your payday.
Checking the cash.
You want to get your money in a hurry. You want it from a friendly place that's got a lot of class.
Checking the cash, checking the cash.
When you get a money mayday, checking the cash.
We're back on Sports Vision, the magazine, right here on WTMB. Referee of fire.
Dogs are going at it back and forth. Hey, we got some Bear Classic. We were only able to get one game. It was a lot of rain outs and stuff and scheduling and time, but we did get Bradley and Eastridge, and I think Joe's got it. Let's roll the tape.
I think so, huh?
I think so. Right, here we go.
We pick it up. The score, if you'll see here, 2-0, bottom of the third. Josh Reagan leads off with a single to right field for the Bars. Jimmy Mitchell would walk. Two on, no out for Bradley. All right, Brent Stewart now sends a dribbler to the mound. Eastridge pitcher.
Throws it away, right?
Throws it away. Reagan would score. It's 3-0. Bradley. Oh, my goodness. Catcher Tyler Westmoreland gets a single through the shortstop hole. He scores. Mitchell does a good job of base running, taking second on a throw. And Westmoreland, tell you what, big old boy there. Pitcher Aaron Briscoe. We know Aaron here. He hits one to the shortstop. He beats out the throw. Another bear would score. Overthrow. Sends Briscoe to second base. Oh, my goodness. Here we go. Shane Ware hits the ball through the shortstop. Nice diving try there. However, it's a single for Ware. A wild pitch now would bring home another run for Bradley as they're just putting it on right now. Skylar Sherland for the Bears would walk. However, the threat would end. The Bears tally 5 times. It's 7-0 after 4. You can see there. Bottom of the 5th up 7-1. Bears, Kellen Pickle would walk. They try to pick Pickle. Pickle will say that fast 157 times. They try to pick him, and Pickle is not picked.
Watch this piece of base running here.
He goes to second. And how many peppers can Kellen Pickle pick? He gets third base. My goodness. Stewart would double him home, makes it 8-1. Right there on a nice smack. Westmoreland now, the big man, gets an infield single for the Bears. Bradley with the runner at first and second now. The runners would move to second and third right here on that wild pitch. Well, who was he throwing it to there? Well, he was throwing it to Denise.
He should be throwing it to Bristol, but Bristol.
All right, here we go. Bristol would drill a shot to the shortstop. 2 scores, 10-1 now. The route is on. Bradley, big lead over East Ridge. Ware walks. Again, try to say that fast. Ware walks. First and second again for the Bears. And Sherland.
Off the single to end the game.
On a single.
There's a 10-run lead.
That goes right there. Makes it 10 runs. And then that is that.
Bob Schuyler doing a good job.
11-1. Final score, game ends in the 5th inning.
Young sophomore, Joel's got to be proud of that. There's some more scores from that, Joe. The Bear Classic scores. Bradley beat Mag 7-3. They also beat East Ridge, as you just saw, 11-1, 10-run rule, 6-4. Cleveland over Cumberland County. And Cleveland also beat McCauley in that 9-3. And Baylor nips Bradley 5-3. We're moving on.
All right, Lenore City Classic scores. Walker Valley beats McMinn Central 11-1. Walker Valley over Harriman 9-1, and Walker Valley beats Eaglesville 10-0.
And they won the Lenore City Classic. So how about the Walker Valley Mustangs? Well, listen, we're going to keep moving. We got some industrial. We're going to go from the big guys down to the little guys.
Yeah.
All right,
here we go. From me to you.
Yeah, from me to you. Yeah. Well, yeah. All right, here we go. 9-10, Mets Cubs. Let's roll it.
Take it.
All right, we're at it. My man's on top of it. Pick it up. Cubs in the first inning. Shelby Rommel. He's going to rip one. Look at this. It's going to be an ISGD, whatever inside the park Homer stands for. The synonym, the acronym. He hits one. Rommel.
And Rommel comes again.
Yeah, he marches through Germany, whatever he did. 21, Judah Ward. Judah. He would get a triple right here, almost in the identical spot. Watch this. Ward comes around, and he is safe at third base. Next pitch, the pass ball. Ward pulls around from there to third base. Now he's going to get by. Now watch Ward. He's going to try to come in. It's going to be a pretty good hustle by the Mets. Nice play.
Ooh.
Toss to the pitcher. He's out. So it's 1-0 for the Cubs. Top of the first. We're going to move to the bottom of the first. That always comes after the top. Right here, Asher Spencer is going to beat out an infield roller. Look at that. Asher flies down the line.
On Asher, on Dasher, on Prancer, and on
there we go. Spencer's going to get a second base right here. Stolen. And as they often do, as we get down to the lower leagues, he's going to steal third base. There he is, Asher Spencer on third base. Brandon, don't call me Pat Zajac. He's going to walk right here for the Cubs. Brandon approves of that. And he's going to make a play here. If the ball's going to get through, they're going to make a play on him as he starts down here. Zajac's going to score. And then
feeling home again.
Here comes Spencer scores. Zajac follows him. A lot of good base running right there by Spencer and Zajac. There we go. Taylor Bledsoe is going to walk it. And the next inning right there it is. 2-1. Top of the second. Zach Walker walks. He's in Zach Walker. He walks. Then here's Colton Reynolds with a walk. So there's two on, no one out. Here we go. Now we've got Arnwine. Caleb Arnwine is going to walk. And the bases are loaded for Cole Paul, who's going to get an RBI with this walk. Attaboy, Cole. 2-2 is his score. That's going to end that inning as, watch this, at home plate is going to be a play. Mets hustling back. Again, as they did earlier, make the play at home. So two runs saved right there. Good job on the defensive side. Bottom two, Andre Kohlmeier walks. That's going to show you 2-2 score. And Cody G. Wally also walks. Cody G. Gonna follow right there.
Oh, look at that shot.
There's a shot by Cody G right there.
Nice shot.
Around the right field line. It'll go for a triple. Two runs are gonna score. It's 4-2. And then watch Cody G. Wally here in a minute. It's a sterling point right there, too. It's gonna show you something special on that right there. Just a little bit. And McGrady, developers out there, doing a good job. G's gonna play with him. Watch this. He's standing there. He's on third base. He's going, I'm going to mess with him here. I'm going to go down. I'm going to stop. I'm going to take off. And then I'm going. Oh, he just misses me. I'm safe. Mess around with him. Now, they appealed that, whether or not he went out of the baseline or not, whether or not it was safe or not. He's going to be safe. This umpire called him out. First base umpire called him safe. It's really kind of a reverse appeal, though.
I think he called him out because he thought he had them.
And the Cubs now are sitting there saying, well, man, we don't know about this. And they're going to argue. They got a protest. They're looking at the bag up there saying, look, hey, we don't like that call. We're going to protest that call. And they're discussing it a little bit. But guess what? It's going to stand. We're going to go back to the action. And Cody G.
Stand as an out or a run?
It's going to stand as a run. And
here
we go.
Out,
actually, Spencer. Well, they had the first base umpire over here with Hunzell. It doesn't happen. Gets the first base. And here we go with Brandon Zajac again. He's going to take another shot to left field. This time, Spencer is going to come all the way around and score. And now Zajac's going to steal third in just a moment on this play right here. And then Zajac is going to wheel his fortune all the way around to home. Watch this. There it is. He's in. 7-2. Mets up. They go on to win by a score of 7-2 also. And let's look at the scoreboard. Wait a minute. Don't we have some graphics?
Oh, not after
no.
that.
All right, well, we got to go to commercial.
Yeah.
That was good. Zajac, wheel of fortune.
No, that stunk. That was bad. Very bad.
Good.
Our buildings and employees do more than take up space. We're more than just checkbooks and loan applications. We are part of this community, just as the community is part of us. Our people have been here for years. We've worked alongside you at the Heart Walk in United Way. We reinvest both time and money, which adds to the quality of life in Bradley County. Any bank can lend money. It takes a neighbor to lend a hand. First Tennessee. All things financial, all things Cleveland, all things community. Member FDIC.
Little known talent right there.
I like to skip a stone across the water every time I hear.
Yeah, and I always kind of just act like I'm carrying fishing pole. Hey, we got a new sponsor on the show who's been doing a great job for us, Sterling Point, and Courtney and Betty McGrady are the owners and developers.
No relation to Tracy McGrady of the Orlando Magic.
And they, Courtney and Betty, have developed that whole Red Food area out there, the Bilo Center out there at the ATP 40, and they've done a great job. They got a street named after them. I'll tell you what, and we got a little surprise for you after that's done, but let's take a look at the dedication that the mayor did because they're great sponsors of ours. We want to show this, and go check this out. It's really nice out there.
Several months ago, I got a letter from Sheriff Gilley suggesting that Red Food Drive be named McGrady Drive, and rightfully so, because of the effort that Betty and Courtney have given to this area of the community. We can see developments here that we never dreamed of having. We see retail trade. We see a win-win situation for everybody. It enhances the quality of life in this area. And I've told Courtney, and I can't imagine a development more perfect than this, because instead of just selling some property, look at it, here it is, here's what it might can look at, any potential buyer can look at it and knows exactly what it's going to look like because it has been perfected. And Dan, thanks to you for the idea. We threw a lot of ideas around, Roland Drive, Gilly Drive, and Betty Drive, and I don't know how the sign came out, but it's gonna be one way or the other. And David May and the members of the City Council voted unanimously, with no hesitation, to name it. And Dan, we appreciate your suggestion, and that really got the ball rolling. And anything you'd like to say?
Well, Tom, I was sitting at the intersection one morning waiting to come through, and I glanced up and noticed that the road into the part of the development had been named Treasury Drive or Treasury Lane. And I got to thinking about Portland, this long, starring career with the Treasury Department. And I thought, well, what more fitting change could take place to name this section of the roadway through this development, the Grady Drive, to match up with his long career with the U.S. Treasury Department. So it just seemed to be a natural fit. That's the danger of sitting there at a traffic light thinking. You're liable to have a good idea every now and then. I was just real pleased that my recommendation was followed through with, and I'm very proud of the Grady's. They certainly deserve it. And being a resident of the South End, I want to say this, for years and years and years, I've heard my neighbors talk about it. The South End never sees any new retail establishments. That all has changed thanks to the Grady's. We on the South End now will have something we'd be very proud of.
And it's all first class, too.
Oh, very,
look at the three banks and the potential and the other things that are coming. You know about auto parts. Business has never been here before in this part of town. Of course, Walmart is going to be like a magnet, not only attracting other businesses, but it's going to attract shoppers as well throughout the area. And on behalf of the City of Cleveland, thank you very much.
The brains behind that is Betty.
Oh, of course. It's so obvious.
Super Center coming in out there. You need to go see that, folks. It's going to be great.
And they are going to have a payload drive. They're going to rename Inman Street. It's a whole other story. We'll talk about that.
I got
that
a little later. Back alley right there behind Pokey's, right between where
it's going. Yeah, I saw that.
Anyway, hey, listen, next week, you people saw us a few years ago, we've been actually racing the Kentucky Derby. We've showed you the proof.
Longer, though.
We've been there, but now we've got a different ploy. We're owners. Why? Because he can no longer be a jockey.
I mean, about 5 pounds.
And me, they don't think it's fair. So they take me off the horse and make
me. Well, we've got to tell them our little attitude. We got a little attitude, little change. You're going to see our horse, our jockey. Our jockey is 6'6 compared to a smaller one, but he weighs 50 pounds.
Right. Anyway, 10 most wanted. Mark it down, 10 most wanted. We'll see you next week, ladies and gentlemen, with
Empire Maker.
10 most wanted.
Empire Maker.
10 most wanted.